This video is about building an instrumentation amplifier out of two op amps. It corresponds to section 40.2 of the Applied Analog Electronics textbook. Now, an instrumentation amplifier has got to have two high impedance inputs, and we only get one high impedance input per op amp because the other one is used in the feedback circuit. So let's just start with two op amps. And for each one, we'll make the positive input be one of the two inputs of the instrumentation amplifier. We'll make the positive input op amp have the output for the circuit. And now we've just got to have some resistors. And we'll have VREF coming in here at the bottom. Let's call this resistor R1, this one R2, and then we'll come back out R2, R1 for the other pair here. It isn't essential that all these resistors be, these two R2s be the same and these R1s be the same, but they usually are because it's easier to match things than to make multiples that are not exact matches. And now we're going to provide the feedback. And there's one more thing we're going to do here, and that is to add a gain resistor connecting the two negative inputs. Okay, this is our circuit. How do we analyze it? Well, unfortunately, we can't just use simple voltage dividers because this node here, we've got three resistors coming together, and there's current through all three of those resistors, so it's not going to be a simple voltage divider, which can only have two resistors with current through them. But there's a solution, and the solution is a fairly simple one. We're just going to go back to first principles, use Kirchhoff's current laws. And so what we've got is that the current into this node and the current into this node have to sum up to zero. All right, so just have to write down those currents and we got the equations. Little problem still, and that is we need to know the voltages for all the nodes because I mean, we've got the resistances. If we want the currents, we need the voltage across the resistors. So what can we do? Well, for this node, that's just connected up to the negative input of this op amp. It's in a negative feedback loop, so that's going to be pulled to the same voltage as the positive input. And this node, same thing going on here. It's a negative input of feedback loop, so it's going to be pulled to the same value as the positive input to that op amp. And that just leaves this node here, which is kind of unknown. Well, let's not worry about that for a moment and just figure out what are the equations for the current law, and maybe we can simplify V2 away. So if we look here, we have V out minus VP over R1 plus V2 minus VP over R2 and plus Vm minus Vp over R gain. Okay, and let's do the same thing down here, and let's put them in the same order of the fractions. So we'll do the ones that are for R1 first. That would be Vref minus Vm over R1 plus, and I guess we had R2 next, so that'd be V2 minus Vm over R2 plus, and then we have Vp minus Vm over R gain. Okay, we've got two equations, two unknowns, V2 and Vout. We're really only interested here in what's Vout. V2, well, we are a little bit interested in that, but let's worry about that later. Okay, so if we wanted to get rid of V2 here, we could just subtract the bottom equation from the top one, and then we'd end up with a V out minus V ref, which looks promising. So let's just do that subtraction. Slide that over, start a new sheet of paper. Okay, so I'm going to take the top equation here minus the bottom equation. And I should end up with V out minus V ref minus Vp plus Vm over R1 plus, well, the V2 minus V2 cancels, so I'll end up with Vm minus Vp over R2 plus, all right, try doing it a little bit differently. And then the last one, we're going to get Vm minus Vp over R gain twice. Okay, that still looks like a bit of a mess, but notice V2 is gone. So what have we got? We've got V out minus V ref, and then we have a bunch of Vm minus Vps. Well, why don't we just move over all those over to the other side, and we'll have V out minus V ref over R1 equals Vp minus Vm times 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2 plus 2 over R gain. And if we get rid of the R1 by multiplying both sides by that, V out minus V ref is Vp minus Vm times 1 plus R1 over R2 plus 2 R1 over R gain. And that is exactly the form we want for an instrumentation amplifier, because what we have is the differential signal here multiplied by a gain to get our single ended output reference to Vref. That's our instrumentation amplifier. Now, I said we did have to worry a little bit about V2. Let's go back and look at V2 again. That's this node here. We have to make sure that that stays within a range in which this second op amp here can produce. I mean, if we needed a V2 here that was, you know, 100 volts or something, we wouldn't be able to achieve it. We'd get clipping here and the whole thing wouldn't work. Figuring out exactly what V2 can be, it can be done by using these two equations, basically. Knowing what V out is, you can substitute it, or V out minus V ref is, you can substitute in for them and clean things up. It's still kind of a mess in terms of the algebra. But the bottom line comes down to the constraints on V2 are reasonable. They're, in fact, a little less strict usually than the constraints you get on the internal nodes of the 3-op amp instrumentation amplifier. So usually you can get a somewhat larger differential signal being handled appropriately by this 2-op amp instrumentation amplifier than you can with the 3-op amp instrumentation amplifier. Depends a little bit on exactly what your common mode is and how big your differential signal is. And the details on that are in the book if you really want to follow up on them. You do need to be aware of this a little bit, in that if you have a large common mode, just like when you have a large common mode with the 3-op amp instrumentation amplifier, that limits the range that you can have for your differential signal. And you can get, if you pick too big a common mode, you can get to the point where this node starts clipping even though the output node doesn't look like it would clip. So you do have to be just a little bit careful. But as long as you keep your common mode signal small, so that it's basically the average of these two signals is staying halfway between your power rails, or staying close to VREF, actually, you're in pretty good shape. Okay, and that's really about it for the 2-op amp instrumentation amplifier.